Hello students, welcome in mechanical department of SSM Mysore Polytechnic SAS Ahmednagar. My name is Akshay Dekhne and today we are going to cover a topic from program code ME5I, that is mechanical engineering fifth semester ISK under the MSPT program, and the course code is AMP, that is Advanced Manufacturing Processes. In that, we are going to start our unit number 1, that is Non-Conventional Machining Processes. In today's lecture, we are going to cover the difference between conventional and non-conventional machining process, advantages of non-conventional machining process, and classification of non-conventional machining process. So let us see the difference between conventional and non-conventional machining, their advantages and classification. We will see all these things with the help of slideshow, with the help of PPT. So let us see PPT. Now let us start the non-conventional machining processes. See what is mean by conventional and what are different non-conventional machining processes. We know that in conventional machining process, certain portion of a workpiece is removed by using cutting tool to change them into final product. For example, in case of lathe machine, we are using a hard cutting tool which is used to remove the portion of a part with the help of cutting tool and to change them into final product. That is nothing but the conventional machining process, or else we can say traditional machining processes. For example, turning, milling, shaping, drilling. Milling and turning, such types of process are traditional ones, and non-conventional means non-traditional. For example, EDM, LBM, USM, EBM, PAM. In non-conventional machining process, what will happen? It is a group of process that cuts the material by using mechanical, thermal, electrical, chemical energy, but do not use a sharp or hard cutting tool. Example, we have seen EDM means electric discharge machining. LBM means laser beam machining. USM means ultrasonic machining. EBM means electric beam machining. PAM means plasma arc machining. Now these name indicates that these are the processes, advanced processes, which are using for cutting the tools, for giving their different shape with the help of advanced machine, with the help of electric beam or laser beam or ultrasonic beam. So we call it as a non-conventional or non-traditional machining process. And what happened in conventional? Conventional means the traditional processes. They are using the hard cutting tool. And in non-conventional machining, they are not using hard cutting tools or sharp cutting tool. Now see the diagram, you will get exactly the difference. I have shown diagram over here, conventional, that means traditional lathe machine or drilling machines, these are the traditional one, and non-conventional or unconventional or non-traditional, these processes are nothing but the, they have used a new technology like laser beam, like electric beam, etc. See the different images which I have shown you in this diagram. Ultrasonic machine, the diagram of laser beam machine, water jet machine, electron beam machine, electric discharge machine, electrochemical machine, abrasive jet machine, like this. All these are the non-conventional machining processes. We can use these type of machines for getting higher productivity, for reducing the time, etc. So in any case, non-conventional machining processes are good one, or they are having the maximum advantages over the conventional machining processes. Okay, now I think so from this slide, from this diagram, you will get the exact idea about the what are conventional machining process and what are non-conventional machining process. Okay, next let us see the difference between conventional and non-conventional machining process. First and very important difference is, in conventional, direct contact tool and workpiece is there. Direct contact of tool and workpiece is there. Means if you are going to cut an object, you have to make the direct contact of tool and workpiece. And in case of non-conventional, tools are non-conventional techniques like laser beam, electric arc, or plasma arc. So you need not touch these tools, such types of tool, to the component or to the workpiece. This is the major difference, because we know that the cutting tool is always harder, but the laser beam or plasma arc, they may or may not be harder than the your workpiece. So the second difference is given: cutting tool is always harder than workpiece, and in non-conventional, tool may or may not be harder, and it may not be physical presence. The beam is there, which may not be physically present. Third and one more difference is, tool life is less due to high wear, and in non-conventional, tool life is more. We know that while cutting the object, there is a friction, and if there is a friction between two mechanical components, then there should be wear. And in conventional processes, in traditional processes, the wear rate is high. So as the wear is high, its tool life will get decreased, or the whole tool life is less. But in case of non-conventional machining process, the tool life is more, because as there is no physical contact between workpiece and tool, so there is less chances of friction, ultimately the less chances of wear. Next difference is, in case of conventional milling process or traditional milling process, generally microscopic chips are formed. Microscopic chip formation is more in conventional. Means, for example, if you are drilling a component, if you are drilling a plate, then what will happen? The chips or burrs are produced, are formed in case of conventional milling processes. In case of non-conventional milling process, material remover occur with or without chip formation. Some non-conventional or some advanced processes, there are chip formation, there may be chip formation or may not be chip formation. But in maximum cases, in maximum non-conventional machining processes, material remove occur without chip formation. So there is less chip formation. So will not get the burr or extra material from the workpiece. The next difference is, material remove takes place due to application of cutting force. In case of conventional, this traditional process, material removal takes place due to application of cutting force. Means you have to apply the cutting force, then and only then you will get the material removal rate. you have to apply high cutting force, then and only then you will get the high material removal rate. But in case of non-conventional machining process, it uses different energy like electrical, thermochemical, thermal, laser, etc. to provide machining. So the material removal rate ultimately goes higher, which will be beneficial to the customer also and the producer also. The manufacturer industries are using advanced technologies for the machining of different objects. One more important difference is conventional machining processes are suitable for all types of material, and non-conventional processes are not suitable for all types of material. Why? See, suppose we are using laser beam, then laser beam will not be suitable for all type of material. But we are using a hard cutting tool, which will be applicable for all type of materials. Next and important difference is it cannot be used to make prototype parts very effectively. What it means, in conventional or in traditional processes, these processes will not be used to make the prototype. We know that in industry, number of applications are there which requires prototype. Number of components are there which requires prototype. Or else, some students are making projects for their project, prototype is also essential. So we cannot use the conventional machining process to produce a prototype, because it requires much more financial support, it requires much more time duration. We have to give the maximum energy for making the parts or prototype, so that it is not convenient with the conventional machining process. And what happened in non-conventional machining process, it can be used to produce prototype parts very effectively. Means within a short period of time, you can produce the different prototypes, or they may be effective as per your requirement. So this is the basic difference of conventional and non-conventional machining processes. Next, the advantages of non-conventional machining processes. First advantage is any material can be machined irrespective of its hardness. If you want to machine any type of material, it may be hard or smooth, you can use non-conventional machining process. Okay. Next advantage is any complicated shape can be produced on the workpiece. In case of conventional milling process, conventional machining process, if you want to shape or if you want to manufacture a complicated shape, if you want to produce a complicated shape, then it is a much longer process. It required different cutting tools. It is time consuming process. But it is advantage of non-conventional process that any shape, if you want to manufacture, if you want to produce, you can produce easily. Okay, this is one of the great advantage of non-conventional machining process, because day by day we know that a human being required a shape that may be complicated but very very useful for their daily life, for their different products. So this is advantage of non-conventional machining process over the conventional or over the traditional machining process. Okay. Next advantage is very fine holes can be easily drilled. Even if small diameter hole also drilled with the help of non-conventional machining processes, which will not be possible with the help of conventional machining process. Okay. The part produced are burr-free. We know that in conventional machining process, that may be turning, that may be drilling, that may be a facing operation. In all the operations, you will get the burr in case of traditional process, in case of conventional process. But in case of non-conventional machining process, the parts produced are burr free. Drilling of tapered hole is also possible with the help of non-conventional process. So these are the advantages of non-conventional machining process. Now see the classification of non-traditional or non-conventional machining process. First, we'll classify it on the basis of thermal, EDM, wire cut EDM, LBM, IBM, EBM, EDG, and PAL. Electric discharge machining, that is EDM. The next version or next advancement in EDM is the wire cut EDM, wire cut electric discharge machining. LBM, that is laser beam machining. Ion beam machining, IBM. EBM, that is electron beam machining. Electric discharge grinding, PAM, that is plasma arc machining. So while observing all these things, we know that non-conventional or non-traditional process having a lot of use, as they are using laser, as they are using electron beam, as they are using for a grinding purpose, they are using plasma arc. So it is having much more importance in your industrial life. Next, we'll categorize the non-traditional machining process under the mechanical. First one is abrasive jet machining, AJM. Second is ultrasonic machining, that is USM. Third one is WJM, that is water jet machining. Next, electrochemical. Electrochemical machining and electrochemical grinding. Then electrochemical grinding and electrochemical machining. After that, we have one more under the chemical category, chemical machining, CHM. So all these are the classification of non-traditional machining process. By observing all these things, we know that how much these processes are important. Okay. Now see, in this lecture, what we have seen is different non-conventional processes, difference between the conventional and non-conventional, their advantages, and the classification. So in this lecture, we have completed what are different types of non-conventional processes, why they are important, what are different advantages. So in non-conventional machining processes, we'll do multiple operations with the help of multiple tools and multiple applications, which are the advanced applications. Okay. Thank you, student. Thank you very much.